So most recently, I went through a horrible, a family event, we'll call it familial homicide, and my sister was taken from us. She was actually unalived by her son. My nephew had a psychotic break, and this was just totally unexpected. He had normally been doing very well. So most recently, I went through a horrible, a family event, we'll call it familial homicide. And my sister was taken from us. She was actually unalived by her son. My nephew had a psychotic break. And this was just totally unexpected. He had normally been doing very well. And so when this happened, it turned the family upside down. He was arrested immediately. He's schizophrenic, and he made a call to the police department and said that, he was at Buckingham Palace or something like that. And so all of this hit the news. It was on a continuous loop, and there was just a lot to deal with. I had never, ever thought anything like this could happen to my family. My sister was very respected in the community, 39 years in the education system, and it was enough to take me out. But because I had these practices in place, I was able to gather myself. So normally I would do the hour of power, just an hour, but this time I was doing it like a few hours each day just to, just get myself settled. And so I look back on these practices and realize that if you have to be doing something to fill yourself up every day, or else a nightmare can happen and it can just topple you over. I definitely have my moments where I'm still questioning what the hell happened, or crying or things like that. I still do feel fragile, but I'm able to walk around and pursue my interests, and that in its of itself is a miracle. So you have to be able to build, have some kind of mindset practice to fortify yourself, because we're on this path of life and you never know how it's going to change.